In the last two chats, we listened to how much the choice of chords has to do with creating certain styles of music. In chat 28, special effects part 2, John Carlini will clue us in on some of the special timbre effects that can be created on the guitar. But before we do that, I would just like to remind you that I am George Mariner Moll, Artistic Director of the Discovery Orchestra, and we would like to again say, if there is a musical or listening topic that you would like us to take up in one of these chats, just email your request to info@discoveryorchestra.org, and we will do our best to accommodate your request and let you know when it's going to be in the queue. Hey, John.
George, great to be back.
Thank you. Now, another special effect that can be produced on a stringed instrument is the audible glissando, or gliss, as it's sometimes called. Now, on the piano, we can play very distinctly from one pitch to another. Let's say I go, let's go all the way up there, okay? But if I slide or glide my fingers over the piano keys, all the, now we can hear that on the piano, each pitch does sound distinctly, however briefly. But the human voice and a fretless stringed instrument can do this with non-distinct pitches intervening, creating something called a continuous glissando or a portamento. Now, when I first began to study a stringed instrument, I, like all other beginning string students, began practicing shifting exercises to get my hand and ear used to functioning from different starting points on the fingerboard, known as positions, first position, second position, third position, and so forth. And I also remember hearing the voice of my dear father from another location in our house, saying to my mother, "Helen, he knows how to play the piano. Does he have to take up that thing?" As you can imagine, hours of shifting exercises. Could really get to you after a while. In any event, glissandos, or glisses, as they are sometimes called, even have other names used by musicians. Sometimes people call them slides, or sweeps, or even smears, or bends. John, what do guitarists call these things?
We see them as glissandi, or glissando,
okay. Or
slides.
All right. Okay, those three words. All right, now, could we have some sort of guitar demo?
Sure.
Of a passage with a slide and without it, so we could hear it both ways.
Sure. Here's an original exercise.
Okay.
That I use for just that.
Now, could you slow-mo one of these slides somewhere?
Sure.
Show us. Go back again. Ah. Okay. So we can really hear those movements over those frets. Yeah. All right. Now we'll end this chat with John playing, the original composition that he played for us again. And I want you to listen for slides or glissandos that are audible. And also, if you'll notice, toward the very end, we get some harmonics, and we'll see you for Discovery Chat 29.